Hey, what's up, everybody? My name is Miss Win C. Can you say it? Miss Win C. Can you clap it? Miss Win C. Can you snap it? Miss Win C. Can you stomp it? Miss Win C. Okay, I have a question for you. Who can tell me how many times we clapped for Miss Win C? Oh, I hear all kinds of guesses out there. I hear 5, I hear 4, I hear 10, I even heard 100. Well, we're gonna find out right now. What you just did, guessing? Guessing is really cool. Scientists guess all the time. But there's something else that's cool too. It's proving your work. And that's what mathematicians do. Anybody out there love math? I know I do. You need it for everything. You can't go to the store without math because you won't know how much money you need to pay for something. Your age, who knows how old they are? Your age is a number. That's right. So you can't know how old you are without math. What about the date? Does anybody out there know today's date? That's right, the date is a number. That's all math. So let's prove our work. Let's prove how many claps are in Miss Win C. Parents and teachers, stay right there because I'm going to ask you to let us use your fingers for what we call one-to-one correspondence. That's right. You put up one finger for each time we clap for Miss Win C. You guys ready? Everybody else, get your clappers ready. Here we go. Let's clap it out. Miss Win C. How many fingers are your parents or teachers holding up? All right. So if your hypothesis was 3, then give yourselves a big round of applause. Excellent. First, we clapped it. Who remembers what we did second? These are ordinal words, parents. That's right, second, we snapped it. And snapping is very important because it helps us strengthen our fingers, or another word for fingers is digits. It helps us strengthen our fingers. All right, are you guys ready? Let's snap Miss Win C. Here we go. Let's snap it out. Miss Win C. Parents, can we use those fingers again? We need to use those fingers to see how many snaps are in Miss Win C. Are you ready? Let's snap it out. Miss Win C. How many fingers are your parents or teachers holding up? 3. Good job. If your hypothesis was 3, give yourselves a big round of applause. All right, and one more. Are you guys ready? What did we do third? We stomped it. Good job. This time, parents, would you please put your hands behind your back? You're still going to put up one finger for each time we stomp, but you're going to show us all the fingers after we give you a drum roll. Are you ready? Here we go. Let's stomp it out. Miss Win C. Okay, wait. Parents, don't show us your fingers yet. We're going to give you a drum roll. But I want to ask my students, how many times did that feel like in your body? Ah, you said 3. Let's give our parents a drum roll. You guys ready? Here we go. All right, parents, and show us your fingers. How many fingers do you see? 3. If your hypothesis is just a big fancy word for guess. If your guess was 3, give yourselves a big round of applause. Excellent. Excellent. Parents, that's a skill called subitizing. If I were to throw a die, when it's 1, it's a die. If it's 2, it's dice. If I were to throw this die and it landed with these numbers facing you, you'd know immediately that this was how many? 4. I even heard some of my students say 4. Excellent. You'd know that this was 4. What about this? 6. Very good. What about this one? 3. Excellent. You'd know that because you now have a skill for seeing numbers and collecting them quickly and giving us a total. That's something our students need to learn. And you can help students learn to subitize by flashing numbers at them so that they can count them, collect them, and give a total sum quickly. Good job again, everybody. Kiss your brains. Because that's where we keep all of our information. Well, my friends down at the New Jersey Performing Arts Center, or we call it NJPAC, that's just a shorter way to say New Jersey Performing Arts Center, asked me to do a story for you guys. You're just in time for story time. I have a question though. Have you ever been to NJPEG? Oh my goodness, you've got to go. You will love it. It's a beautiful building, but not just that. They have shows and classes and something for everybody in your entire family. You gotta go to NJPEG. If you come down, you might see Miss Wincy there. Excellent. Well, it's story time, and anybody who knows Miss Wincy knows that I love books. Anybody here love books? Yes, I love books. I love books because anything you wanna know, anything you wanna do, anything you wanna be, anything you wanna cook, any place you wanna go, you can learn about it by reading a book. That's right, they can't keep anything from you if you read books, because all of the information you'll ever need can be found in a book. And today, story time is about Alvin Ailey. Alvin Ailey was a famous choreographer. That's somebody who dances. You like to dance, boys and girls? You see Miss Wincy's NJPEG shirt? It says, I am dance. I love to dance. A choreographer is someone who teaches other people to dance. He makes the dances up himself, and then he teaches other people how to do them. Let's get ready for the story of Alvin Ailey, the famous choreographer. I'm gonna get my story chair. I'll see you there. Alvin Ailey. 1942, that was a long time ago, boys and girls, at the Truvine Baptist Church. It seemed like the hottest day ever in Navasota, Texas. That was the small town that Alvin Ailey and his mother Lula lived in. Alvin and Lula worshiped at the Truvine Baptist Church every Sunday. When they arrived for services, Alvin slid into his usual seat, the first row pew. The men at Truvine dressed in dignified suits. The women showed off wide-brimmed hats, and they fanned away the Texas heat, like this fan. They fanned away the heat. It was so hot in Texas, boys and girls. All the ladies carried fans. The Reverend Lewis delivered a thundering sermon, and the choir sang a song by a bellow of tenors. They sang, rock my soul in the bosom of Abraham, rock my soul in the bosom of Abraham, oh, rock my soul. Sweet sopranos sang and played tambourines, joining the rousing refrain, oh, rock my soul. The congregation made a joyful noise. They stepped and they swayed, they clapped their hands, and they sang along. Alvin was going to miss the music from the Truvine Baptist Church. That's because only days later, him and his mom would be boarding a train, moving to Los Angeles, California. That's right, times had been hard in Texas, and Alvin's mother wasn't able to find enough work, but she heard that there were many, many jobs available in Los Angeles, California. So that's where she was taking Alvin. Los Angeles was a flashy town. Lula found plenty of work, and most mornings she left the apartment on East 43rd Street before sunrise. That's because she had to work long, long hours, boys and girls. Alvin didn't mind though. On Saturdays and after school, he liked spending time alone. He explored the city streets. That's right, he found a nightclub where he saw that they were always having professional entertainers, singers, dancers, musicians. He loved to read the marquee, that's the big sign outside of the nightclub. Pearl Bailey performing live, Billie Holiday, A Night of Blues, Duke Ellington and his band. The men who owned the theaters stacked handbills, those are like flyers to let you know who's coming, on their stoops. Each flyer or handbill announced who was coming next. One day, Alvin got his hands on a handbill that said, coming soon to the Biltmore Theater, Katherine Dunham and her dancers in Tropical Revue. Alvin looked at the flyer. Catherine Dunham was an African-American woman. Her skin was just like Alvin's. It was brown. He had never seen a brown skin dancer ever. Alvin got excited. He was curious. He put the announcement, the flyer, in his pocket, and he went and told his friend. His friend's name was Ted Crum. Ted was a skinny boy. And Ted knew all kinds of things about dancing. He wanted to dance on stage someday. They made a plan. Alvin and Ted decided that they would sneak down to the Biltmore Theater on the night that Catherine Dunham and her dancers were coming. They pushed the door open just a little bit so that they could peek in and see Catherine Dunham and her cast of brown-skinned dancers. They had never seen anything like it. Alvin nudged Ted. What is that they're doing? What is that? That's modern dancing, Ted told him. Alvin thought he'd try it. He slapped out a beat on his knees, and then he began to move. He curled his shoulders from the back to the front and rippled his hands like an ocean wave. He rolled his hips in a steady, easy swivel, dancing with expression all on his own without ever having taken a lesson. That night, Alvin told Lula, his mom, that he had seen black people performing on a stage. It was a show Alvin would never, ever forget. He wanted to study dance. Shortly after, he enrolled in a school, Lester Horton's Dance School. Boys and girls, if there's something you want to do, you should find the school that will teach you how to do it. Alvin began dancing just the way Lester Horton taught him, but shortly after, he started making up his own moves. What is he doing? A couple of the students asked. Whatever he's doing, he's sure doing a great job of it. That was the beginning of Alvin Ailey's career as a choreographer. He danced at Lester Horton's school almost every day. Eventually, he joined Lester Horton's dance company. That means that he started performing professionally. He started getting paid. So he wasn't just a student anymore. He was also working with Lester Horton. After that, Alvin moved to New York. He was glad to be in New York where he could study ballet and modern dance techniques from a woman named Martha Graham. He took dance classes all over town. He met dancers who showed him moves he had never seen before. So many dancers were black, just like Alvin Ailey. Their dreams soared higher than the New York skyscrapers. Alvin gathered some of those dancers. He went around, he said, hey, you want to dance with me? Hey, you want to dance with me? I'm starting my own dance company. You want to dance with me? About 9 of those dancers, men and women, believed in Alvin's dream. They believed in the dream of the Alvin Ailey Dance Company. Alvin started choreographing. Remember, I said choreography is when you make up dances and you teach them to other people. He started choreographing special dances to blues and gospel songs. This was the beginning of the Alvin Ailey American Dance Theater. In 1960, gospel harmonies filled the 92nd Street Y in New York City. That's right, they sang, rock my soul in the bosom of Abraham, rock my soul in the bosom of Abraham, oh, rock my soul. And Alvin clapped his hands just the way he did when he was a little kid, but this time, his professional dancers filled the space. They began moving and swaying and swinging, wailing and flailing their arms to a piece he named Revelations. He created it to celebrate his traditions. Traditions are things people learned a long time ago and they did over and over again. He did it to celebrate the traditions that he had learned at the True Line Baptist Church in Navasota, Texas. The audience swayed in their seats as his company gloried in their dance. High-stepping ladies appeared on stage sweeping their skirts. They danced with grace and haughty attitudes. That means that they were super proud of themselves. Alvin and the other men jumped lively to the rhythm, strutting and dipping in a sassy revelry. The dance suite. Suite is when you put a group of things together. The dance suite revelations honored the heart and the dignity of Black people while showing hope and joy for everyone. Taking a bow at the end of the dance, Alvin let out a breath. He raised his eyes toward heaven. He was satisfied and proud. And that is the story of Alvin Ailey. Thank you, boys and girls. Look for me online, where I'll be telling another one of these stories from the NJPAC Books on the Move series. See you soon. Well, hello, parents, teachers, students. My name is Miss Win C. Can you sing? Can you clap it? Can you snap it? Can you stomp it? Excellent. And my friends down at NJPAC Community Engagement and NJPAC Arts Education asked me to create another interactive storytelling session for you so that you can have some fun right where you are. You may have seen me in your local neighborhoods or community centers doing the NJPAC Books on the Move program, or you may have even had me in your classroom doing an arts integration lesson. Well, I'm so excited because we can be together right now while you're at home and I'm at home. Now, today I've got all kinds of fun activities planned for you. We're going to do one of our Books on the Move storytelling sessions, and we're going to need an instrument for you to play, okay? Today, I'm thinking we could make our own drum, okay? What you're going to need is a container from your house. This is an old container that used to have cornmeal in it. Cornmeal is something that you use, it kind of looks like grits, and you use it to make fish or cornbread. Ask your parent or your mom or dad, grandmom, pop, if you can pour the ingredients out of the cornmeal container. You can decorate it just the way you want, and we're going to use it as a drum. When we're done, if they want it back, you can give it back. You can put the cornmeal back in it, but right now, we're going to use it as our drum so that we can play some of the sounds from the story that I'm going to be telling you, all right? So we'll pause right now. Why don't you go and get what you need to make a drum, okay? Okay, so did you get everything you need to make the drum that you want? There's no wrong way to do it. I brought in another container of cornmeal, right? And this is what I used to create this one. So I emptied the ingredients out. And then I happen to have some color paper at my house. You can use any kind of paper you want. One of the coolest things is you could just use white paper or lined paper. Cover your container. You're going to need some tape, all right? Or glue, if you have glue. So cover your container all the way around. Tape it. And then if you have markers or pencils and you want to design it any way you want, pictures, your name, whatever you want, that will be your drum that we will use for the rest of this session, okay? Okay, so you have your drum made? Great, we're gonna need that so that we can tap out the claps, the snaps, and the stomps in my name, Miss Win C. All right, parents, teachers, please stay with us because I'm going to be explaining the educational and developmental value in everything that I do today, okay? All right, so we just snapped, clapped, and stomped Miss Win C. Not necessarily in that order. So my first question for you is, who can tell me what we did first? Was it a snap? Was it a stomp? Was it a clap? Which one was it? Mm-hmm. Okay. I heard all kinds of guesses. Who said snapping? Who said stomping? Who said clapping? If you said clapping, clapping was first. While you clap, Miss Wincy, parents and teachers, that's your job, okay? We're gonna play it on our new drum. Are you guys ready? Here we go, get the drum out. I'm gonna play on the bottom. You guys ready? I'm gonna hold it with one hand and play it on the other. Let's do it, here we go. Miss Wincy. Let's do that again. You should be playing your instrument while your parents or your teachers clap their hands. Here we go, let's do it again. Miss Wincy. Great job. Okay, parents and teachers, we have a new job for you. We're going to continue to play Miss Wincy on the drum. Would you put up one finger for each time we tap our drum? This is what you call one-to-one correspondence. Are you guys ready? Here we go. We're going to play Miss Wincy on the drums, but now our parents or teachers are going to put up one finger for each time we tap our drum. All right, this is going to prove how many claps, taps, snaps, stomps are in Miss Wincy. Are you guys ready? You ready with those fingers, parents? Here we go. You guys got your drum? Here we go. Let's do it. Here we go. Miss Wincy. Look at your parents, your teachers. Look at their fingers. How many fingers are they holding up? I'll give you time to count them. Let's count them together. Here we go. One, two, three. If your hypothesis or your guess, that's just a big fancy word for guess. If your guess was three, give yourselves a big round of applause and kiss your brains. That's where we keep all of our good information. So first we clapped it. Who remembers what we did second? Another ordinal word, parents. Who remembers what we did second? Okay, great. Some of you said stomped it. Some of you said snapped it. If your hypothesis or your guess or your recall, you remembered that we snapped it second, you're absolutely right. Give yourselves a big round of applause. Excellent. Now we're going to snap it again. Parents, this is good for fine motor skills. Our students need to learn to use their digits, their fingers. Right now, because of the tablets and the phones, we really only use our thumbs. So in order to strengthen these fingers, we need to do activities with our fingers. Okay, we're going to snap Miss Wincy. All right, are you guys ready? Get those fingers ready. You can put your drum down for a second. Get those fingers ready. Parents, would you put up one finger for each time we snap? You guys ready? Here we go. Miss Wincy. Look at your parents' fingers. How many fingers are they holding up? If your hypothesis was three, give yourselves a big round of applause. Kiss your brain. Very good. And who remembers what we did third? I hear you out there. We stomped it, right? We're going to stomp it right now, okay? But this time, parents, I need you to hide your fingers behind your back. Don't show us your fingers, okay? We're going to do something really special this time with the stomp. Are you ready? Okay, are you guys ready to do the very special stomping of my name, Miss Wincy? Are you ready? Here we go. Get those stompers ready. What do we stomp with? Our feet. Okay, are you guys ready? Here we go. Let's stomp it out. Miss Wincy. Okay, parents, don't show us your fingers. Okay? Don't show us your fingers yet. We're going to give you a drum roll. But before we do, I want to ask you, students, how many did that feel like in your body? How many times did it feel like you stomped? If you said three, we're going to find out if we're right. right now. Are you guys ready? Let's give our parents a big drum roll. You guys ready? Here we go. Let's give them a drum roll. All right, parents, and show us your fingers. Count them. How many is it? It's three. Three fingers. Very good. Give yourself a big round of applause. Parents, that's a skill that young students need to learn. It's called subitizing. For instance, if I were to throw a die, you guys know what this is, right? This is a die. When it's one, it's called a die. If it's two, then it's dice. If I were to throw a die and it landed there, parents would be able to look at that number immediately and say, that's a six. If it landed there, that's a five. If it landed there, boys and girls, you probably know this one. That's a one. How about this one? That's a two. Exactly. That's what you call subitizing. When you can look at a collection of items and tell in one look how many there are, that's what you call subitizing. Good job. And so we should have all gotten the same number of claps, snaps, and stomps for my name, Miss Wincy. We should have all come up with the number three. There are three claps, snaps, stomps, or another big fancy word, syllables in my name, Miss Wincy. Excellent. Give yourselves another big round of applause. You guys are off to a great start for this lesson. Well, I'm glad you decided to join me for story time. Anybody who knows Miss Wincy knows that I love books. I love books because anything you want to do, anything you want to be, any place you want to go, anything you want to learn, anything you want to do, anything you want to cook, you can learn about it by reading a, that's right, boys and girls, by reading a book. They can never hide anything from you as long as you can read. That's why it's so important to practice reading, because all of the information for everything and anything can be found in a book. That's right, can be found in a book. And if I were to walk you around my house, you'd see books everywhere. Miss Wincy has stacks and stacks of books and bookcases with all kinds of books on all different topics and subjects, because I love to read. I love books because I love information and knowledge. And that's why I love the library. And even though we can't visit the library together today, we can visit the library by going through a book in our imagination. So let's see which book we should do today. I've got some great books here. Let's see. I have Tito Puente, The Mambo King. I have Skit Scat, Raggedy Cat. That's the story of Ella Fitzgerald, a great jazz singer. I have Celia Cruz, The Queen of Salsa. I have Timbaland. I have Alvin Ailey. I have some other great books. You know what? Today, how about we explore the story of Timbaland? And don't worry, boys and girls, if I didn't pick one of these books this time, you can catch me online doing one of these books at another time. But today, I'd like to focus on the story of Timbaland. I love this story because when Timbaland, who is a music producer, was little, he decided he wanted to have something to do with music. And he kept that dream alive by working it and studying music, and practicing music and making beats. And so when he grew up, guess what he became? A music producer. And Miss Wincy has a similar story, because when I was little, I wanted to be a teacher and a singer. And guess what I am today? What'd you say? Say it louder. That's right. I'm a teacher who sings and a singer who, you got it, a singer who teaches. And so if it was true for Timbaland and it's true for Miss Wincy, then it's true for you. Whatever you want to do or be, you can make that dream come true when you grow up. Right now, I'd like to stop and find out who's in the room with me. What do you want to be when you grow up? Now, some of you may not know for sure, but you know how you can decide what you want to be? By thinking about the things that you like to do. So if you like to dance, maybe you'd like to be a dancer when you grow up. If you like to help other people learn things, maybe you'd like to be a teacher, like me. If you like music, maybe you'd like to be a musician. If you like to help people when they're not feeling so well, maybe you want to be a doctor. If you like to play video games, maybe you want to be a gamer. There's a profession, like a job, for everything that you love. So whatever it is that you love, think about that right now. And then I want you to turn to the person who's watching this with you, if it's your parent, if it's your teacher, if it's one of your friends, a family member, I want you to turn to them and say, I like to do this, so when I grow up, I'm going to be a, and then fill in that blank. Go ahead, I'll wait. All right, boys and girls, I'm glad that you got a chance to tell us what you want to be. I heard all kinds of professions. Those are what you call jobs, vocabulary, parents. Those are what you call jobs. So I heard doctors. I heard specific kinds of doctors like veterinarians. I heard police persons. I heard fire persons. I even heard some people say they want to be superheroes. I heard some people say they're going to be mommies and daddies. That's very cool, too. I heard people say that they're going to be surgeons. That's a special kind of doctor. That's right. Yes, you can be all of those things. You can keep shouting them out. Yes, ballerinas, sure. Absolutely, why not? You can be anything you want to be. That's awesome. So now, let's listen to the story of Timbaland. All right, let me get my story chair. Okay, boys and girls, I have my story chair now, and I'm excited because I'm going to need your help with this story. Who's going to help me? What about you? You didn't raise your hand. Okay, great. Thank you. I'm excited that you're excited and that you're going to help me. This story has two really important parts in it for you. One of the things that I'm going to need you to do is I'm going to need you to be the sound effects. That means whenever I give you a word that makes a sound like, let's see. Oh, I'm gonna need rain. Oh, I'm gonna need thunder. I need you to make those sounds. You can make them with your mouth. You can make them with the drum that we just made. Or if you were a part of an earlier lesson that Miss Wincy taught and you learned how to make a shaker with a water bottle and rice, you can make the sound with your shaker, okay? If you want to know how to make a shaker, you want to look for one of my earlier stories. It's very simple. You just take a water bottle and put some rice in it. Empty the water bottle out, okay? Make sure you shake it a little bit so that it dries the water inside of it. Pour a little rice into it and put the top on it, and now you have a shaker. All right, if you guys are ready, I'm gonna need you to do two things. So one is the sound effects. And the other thing that I'm gonna need you to do is listen for rhyming words, okay? I might leave a space for you to fill in the blank and you fill it in with the words that rhyme. Are you guys ready? Good, let's get started. Timbaland, Nighttime Symphony. Hey there, darling baby child. You're safe in here, though the storm is wild. Let me get closer so you can see that picture. See that? The street lights glow so dark and deep. But safe and sound, you'll go to, what do you think the rhyming word would be for that? Oh, if you said sleep, you're right. Do you hear the raindrops tap? Can you make a tapping sound? I think our drum would be great to make a tapping sound. Let's try a tapping sound on our drum. Tap, Good. Those sound like raindrops to me. Let me hear yours. Tap, 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 tap. Good job. Good job. Upon the windows of your neck, the clouds pour down a steady beat to soothe your slumber beneath the... What do we sleep under? Right, beneath the sheets. Good job. The cars outside. Can I hear the sounds of cars? Oh, good. I hear your motors. I hear the horns blowing. I love it. The cars outside on streets so wet, their headlights cast a silhouette. A silhouette is like a shadow. Like if Miss Wincy had a curtain in front of her, you wouldn't be able to see my whole face, but you might be able to see the outline of my body. That's what you call a silhouette. Let's say it, boys and girls. Silhouette. Say it again. Silhouette. Who wants to tell me how many claps in silhouette? Let's try it. Silhouette. Let's play it on our drums. You ready? Let's play it on our drums. Let's try it. Here we go. Silhouette. Oh, I didn't give you enough time to get your drum. Get your drum. Let's try it again. Here we go. Silhouette. How many was that? Awesome. Some of you didn't even need your parents' fingers this time. You guys are so smart. Kiss those brains. Those brains are working today. Of trees waving arms up in the air. Can you wave your arms in the air? Wave them like trees. Wave them. Let me see you wave your arms in the air. Wave them up in the air. This way and that way. I love it. Yes. They dance for us like they just don't care. Dancing arms and dancing trees. Radios sing in every home. Steady like the city's metronome. A metronome is a device that keeps a steady beat for you. How many of you play instruments? You play an instrument? Some of you say you play the drums. What about you guys? What else? Somebody says they play the piano. Oh, you take violin in school? Excellent. Guitar, I love it. Well, sometimes when you're practicing, your teacher might say, put up a metronome to make sure that you keep the tempo. Tempo is how fast or slow something goes. So a metronome will make sure that you keep a steady beat so you don't speed up and you don't slow down. Very good. The bass is a pillow, soft and warm. The whole world's tuned to the quiet storm. That's right, the quiet storm. Is that lightning across the sky? Thunder soon comes crashing by. Let me hear the loud sound of thunder. How do you make thunder? Oh, sometimes we make thunder on our thighs. Thunder can be on our thighs. Sometimes we can stomp our feet for thunder. I have a big crash of thunder that I make with my cymbal. Loud, right? Really loud. Nice. Don't worry, little one. The angels too are musicians. Look at these angels playing instruments. Just like you guys. You guys are angels today playing instruments. Hear the gutters rush like rivers. Don't cry or worry, shake or shiver. Can I see you shiver? When do we shiver? Let me see you shiver. What makes you shiver? What'd you say? When you're cold, sure. When you're scared, definitely, definitely. No flood will pour in the place we stay. That's just the music the water plays. The wind, it howls. Let me hear some howling. Ooh, I love it. I love it. I hear you guys louder howling. Ooh, let me hear you howl until I put my hands down. Let me hear it louder, 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 and stop. Good howling. It blows. Can I hear the wind blow? Remember, you're my sound effects. Let me hear the wind blow. I love it. It sings. How about some singing? Excellent. Excellent. Nature's voice, melody, and strings. Don't fear the raging storm so strong. We'll remix the raging into a song. Nice. Last looks from nighttime, windows high, an umbrella sea of passersby. With each turntable above each head, you're the DJ to spin your sweet self to bed. Rain clouds blanket the whole wide world. Inside the sounds of the storm, you curl. Sure, like a crescent moon of rest, the tempest soon becomes your nest. Excellent. When the morning comes around, you'll remember every sound. Let's make all those sounds. What were the sounds? Yes, it was howling. Let me hear the howling. Yes, it was singing. Let me hear the singing. Yes, what else? Yes, there was thunder. Let me hear the thunder. I love it. Yes, what else? Oh, raindrops tapping. Let me hear the tapping. I love it. Excellent, excellent. Sun breaks through the cloudy sky. The storm was just a lullaby. A lullaby. Excellent. Give yourselves a big round of applause. And you know, my favorite part in this story was when he said they dance for us like they just don't care. He talked about waving arms and trees that dance through a storm with arms up in the air, dancing for us like they just don't care. I think this is a great time for us to put on a Timberland song and get a little exercise. You guys ready to do some moving? That's right. We'll get those arms moving, maybe even those legs moving, okay? Ready? You guys need to stand up. All right, move your drum out of the way. Make sure you have a little bit of space around you. I'm gonna get one of the Timberland songs and we're gonna do some moving together. You guys ready? Here we go. Okay, boys and girls, teachers and parents, I'm glad you decided to join me for the exercise portion of the Timberland story. I want you to understand how important it is that we exercise, that we move our bodies and our muscles and get the blood flowing through these organs so that our minds can stay healthy. Even though we're inside, we can still move around right in our homes or right in our classrooms and get the exercise that we need. So we're gonna do that to a Timbaland song based on the Timbaland Nighttime Symphony story. So I wanna teach you some very simple moves, okay? I wanna practice them with you before we actually start the music. All right, so one of the things that's gonna be really important is that we inhale. That's when you take a breath in. So let's inhale. And then when I say exhale, we're gonna blow it out of our mouths. Let's try that. Now, I wanna practice these exercises with you so that when the music starts and we're gonna exercise to a Timbaland song, you two parents, you two teachers, when the music comes on, you'll already know when I call a cue or a certain movement, you'll already know what I'm talking about, okay? So the first thing we're gonna do is we have to make sure that we're breathing when we exercise. You don't hold your breath when you exercise. So we're gonna take a lot of air into our lungs. That's where the air goes in. So we're gonna take a nice deep breath in, all right? And I have what we call a sphere. Okay, I have a sphere to show you what's actually happening in your lungs when you take a lot of air in. So everybody, let's try it. Let's inhale. And we're gonna blow it out through our mouths slowly. Here we go. Again, let's inhale. Blow it out slowly. One more time, and when we inhale, we're taking the air into our nostrils. The nostrils are these two little holes on our nose. You guys ready? Here we go, let's inhale. Blow it out slowly. Good job. So I'll be reminding you throughout the exercise that you need to make sure that you are breathing. When I say breathe, make sure you inhale and exhale. Okay. Our next movement will be the elbow thigh. Okay. So everybody, where's your elbow? That's right. It's right there. Okay. This is for body parts, parents. So this is sort of like a problem solver. How can you touch your elbow to your thigh? How can you do it? All right, I see somebody. Okay, you sat back down to do it, but we need to be standing for this part of the exercise. Somebody else? Okay, so I saw somebody bend over. Can you do it without bending over? How would you have to do that? Can you solve that problem for me? Right, you have to raise your thigh to your elbow like that. Can you do that? So you can raise your thigh to your elbow. It calls for a little balance, all right? So if I say elbow, thigh, elbow, thigh, elbow, thigh, elbow, thigh. Can we switch now? Elbow, thigh, elbow, thigh, elbow, thigh, elbow, thigh. Good job. So when I call elbow, thigh, you know what to do, okay? The next thing that I'll be asking you to do is shoulders high, okay? We carry stress. I don't know what kinds of things are on your mind, what you might be thinking about, but a lot of the stress, the things that we think about, it kind of like sits in our shoulders. So if we raise our shoulders and drop them, so shoulders high, shoulders high, shoulders high, shoulders high. It's kind of like when you say, what are you saying when you do that? It's called a gesture. I don't know. Let's try that. I don't know. Right. So I might say shoulders high, shoulders high, shoulders high, shoulders high. Can we do that? Parents, this is good teaching the children fine motor isolated movements. Here we go. Shoulders high. Here we go. Let's go. Shoulders high, shoulders high, shoulders high, shoulders high. Good job. Okay. Next, I might ask you to twist right. Your parents and your teachers will help you with what's right and what's left. Twist left. Let's try that. Twist right, twist left. Twist right, twist left. Now don't turn your whole body. Keep your feet straight. Keep your feet pointed at Miss Wincy. Only twist your waist. So you're only gonna twist the top of your body. Twist right, twist left. Twist right, twist left. Great job. All right. Then I might ask you to reach and stretch. Reach and stretch. You're going to get up on your tippy toes for this one. Let's try it. This one calls for a little, what was that word? What was it? Balance. Here we go. Reach and stretch. Reach and stretch. Reach and stretch. Reach and stretch. Good job. Make sure when you stretch, you reach all the way up to the ceiling. See if you can reach the ceiling. Wiggle those fingers. We want to get all of that blood circulating through our bodies. Okay? Then I'll ask you to slap your knees. You're going to slap every other knee. Take this. This is what we call, you know what part of the hand this is? This is called the palm. So you're going to reach over and slap the other knee. Not hard, but here we go with that balance again. You guys ready? Here we go. Slapping knees, slapping knees, slapping knees, slapping knees. Do it with me. Say it when you do it. Slapping knees, slapping knees, slapping knees, slapping knees. Good job. All right, good job. You guys are doing good. And I'll say, make sure you breathe. Make sure you breathe. Don't forget to breathe, because all of this exercise might make you feel like out of breath and you might feel like, I can't even breathe. I can't breathe. Make sure you remember to breathe, okay? All right, and then I'll say, I might cycle. That means I go back through. I might cycle back through another exercise, but make sure we're having fun, okay? Are you guys ready? All right, who's the artist we're focusing on today? Timbaland, that's right. So we're gonna exercise to a Timbaland song. You guys ready? Here we go. All right, you guys ready? We're exercising to our Timbaland song from our story, Timbaland. First, we start with our breathing. Remember, we inhale and then we exhale. We inhale, and then we exhale. Let's go. Do it again, and... Again, and... Inhale, 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 exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, elbow to the thigh, elbow thigh, elbow thigh, elbow thigh, elbow thigh, elbow thigh, elbow thigh, other side, elbow thigh, 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 other side, elbow thigh, 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 other side, elbow thigh, elbow thigh, elbow thigh, elbow thigh, elbow thigh, elbow thigh, elbow thigh. Let's do our shoulders. Are you ready? Get those shoulders ready, okay? We're gonna shrug our shoulders like the I don't know, remember? Here we go. Shoulders high, shoulders high, shoulders high, shoulders high, shoulders high, shoulders high. You say it while you do it. You say it. Shoulders high, again, shoulders high. Shoulders high. Let's do some twisting. Twisting right, twisting right, twisting right. Let's go left, twisting left, twisting left, twisting left. Let's alternate. Twisting right, twisting left, twisting right, twisting left. When you alternate, that means you take turns. Let's keep going. Twisting right, twisting left, twisting right, twisting left. Remember, keep your feet pointed at Miss Wincy. Twisting right, twisting left, twisting right, twisting left, twisting right, twisting left. Now let's reach and stretch. Reach and stretch, reach and stretch, reach and stretch. Up on those tippy toes. Do it again, reach and stretch. Reach and stretch. Let's slap those knees, here we go. Oh, slap those knees, slap those knees. Again, slap those knees with the palm of your hand. Make sure you breathe. Make sure you breathe. Don't forget to breathe. Don't pass out on me. Yeah, wasn't that fun? And now we're done. Give yourselves a big round of applause. You've been an awesome audience. Look for me online where I'll be reading another one of our stories from the NJ Pack Books on the Move series. Who remembers my name? That's right, Miss Wincy. Miss Wincy.